What up, what up, what up, though? Mr. Slate checking in with y'all, man. It's May 22nd, 3:39 p.m. Central Time. I'm always on Central Time for some reason. But yeah, man, got the pre-trip done on the truck, man. We finna get an early start today so we can roll on through the night, man. But yeah, man, we at Truck Life 14, man. So hit the like button, subscribe, man. We gonna keep it pushing. We going up, man. We going up. I'll be right back. Stop. I'm here at a Pilot I-35 in Clay, Missouri. But yeah, man, went to the went in the truck stop, man, get something to eat, man. Soon as I got out the truck, I looked up, saw the Taco Bell sign. I was so tired yesterday and had to clean out my truck, the bottom of the bunk, because I had a mishap. Chattanooga, you know, everybody been through Chattanooga 75. You're going up the upper hill, you know. And I look back, and the damn flames coming all out the back of the trailer, man. I guess the trailer had a bearing fail, wheel bearings had fell on it. So, you know, I had to take my fire extinguisher and put it out, you know what I mean. But, put the fire extinguisher. I'm thinking I blasted the whole can off. I thought I did. Yeah. So I put the can back under, you know, in the utility area, at the, you know, in the little door on the side. Put it back where it was supposed to go. And I guess some more had blasted off under the damn cab. So I had like powder and dust everywhere, man. So it took me about 30-45 minutes, man, to clean all that stuff up, man, and get the truck back right. But yeah, man, Taco Bell, man, right now I can't do it. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna say I never will. Taco Bell ain't that bad. I mean, when you get used to the real tacos, it's horrible. But you know, I guess if it ain't nothing else cracking, ain't nothing else cracking. But I'm not messing with that. I'm not on this road. Not happening. But yeah, man, we gonna talk about rage, man. Keeping you cool out here on the road, because motherfuckers will try you, man. Motherfuckers will try you quick. And it'll be the oldest, scrawniest, crummiest, dirtiest looking motherfucker, man, that will try you, man. They will try you, man. They will get you. They'll get you there, man. But you gotta keep it cool out here, man. You know, you're gonna be going directly to a parking spot one day, and somebody just gonna block it, try to take it. Don't fight over it, man. Go about your day, because you know it only takes a second, man, for something to go totally wrong. You know what I mean? If you're a hothead and you know you're a hothead, your friends done told you you're a hothead, your mama done told you you're a hothead, your pops, your grandma, somebody done told you multiple times you're a hothead. So if you're a hothead, you need to check that shit before you get out here, man. Because you're going to wind up being locked up somewhere you don't want to be. These folks ain't playing out here, man. So just avoid the crowd. It ain't worth it, man. It ain't worth it. Now, if somebody put their hands on you, you know, push you, or, you know what I mean? Hey, man, go for yours, man. They put their hands on you, man. That's what I go by. You know what I'm saying? You can stand over there and talk all you want. I don't talk. I don't do none of that, man. But the minute you put your hands on me, then I'm going ape shit. And I'm pretty sure y'all are the same way. And it's not to say nobody's badder than anybody else. Everybody can get some paint chipped off of them, man. Everybody. Ain't nobody, you know, top dog out here. You know what I mean? Everybody can get their jaw wired up, man. You ain't special, man. You might got some hand game or whatever, but every dog has his day. But you got to keep it cool out here, man. You got to keep it draw you, because a lot of people will try to intentionally draw you into a confrontation, man. Intentionally, man. So just keep your cool, man. Keep your cool, man. There was a situation, man, I think I was in like Montana or something, man. And I was actually, what the hell? I just saw a tire just roll right past me off into the grass. That threw me off, man. But yeah, I was in Montana and it was like this ranch. I was picking up bundles of hay, man. Of all things, bundles of hay, man. And it was a line, but there's a weigh scale that you have to go on. This weigh scale, you got to go on the weigh scale to get checked in. I guess they, you know, weigh your truck and your trailer and everything, and then put the hay on it, and then they weigh you again to get approximate weight of what's been loaded on your truck. But there were a line of trucks off to the side. To me, initially, just pulling up, it looked like they were maybe gonna, you know, stay the night, or I don't know what the case was, but it didn't look like they were in line to me. So I went behind the truck that was lined up to go on the weigh scale, like anybody else would do. But I see a guy walking up on my mirror, and he's walking aggressively. He's red in the face, he's walking aggressively, and you can tell he's like cussing. And I'm like, what the fuck? So I rolled my window down and, you know, looked out, and he was like, what the fuck are you doing? What are you, stupid or something? I'm like, what? I said, what? I said, hold on, man. Like, you know, what's going on? He was like, I've been sitting here for freaking 2 hours. Get your ass in the back of the line. Now, first off, let's get this straight. You get what you put out there, right? You know what I'm saying? You put bullshit out in the universe, you don't get bullshit back. You know what I'm saying? So my thing was this. He could have came to me and said, hey, man, you know, everybody's waiting in line. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to be at the back of the line. I don't know, you know what I'm saying, what happened. Why, you know, somebody cut in front of me or cut in front of us. Anything, man, besides walk up to me like that. Now, what if I was a hothead? What if I was a hothead and opened my door and got out and beat the brakes off that dude? Then I'd have been locked up in Montana. I don't know nobody in Montana. I don't even know nobody remotely close to no freaking Montana. Your truck is towed away. Regardless of who fault it is, you'd have messed up the contract with the company more than likely. So all that, when you could just say, hey, man, like I told him, I said, hey, I appreciate it. If you back up off my truck, you dig, I'll go to the back of the line, but let's get this straight. Don't disrespect me. Don't talk to me like I'm your kid again. And he constantly kept talking stuff. Kept talking. Oh, you're... And then he started to call me names. That's when shit got real, basically. He started to call me names, stupid motherfucker. He put his hat. He had a hat on. Now this shit was funny. I give him this. That shit was funny. He put his hat on to the back, and he pulled his pants down where you can see his nasty ass drawers. And he said, yo, yeah. And then straighten himself up and walk back to his truck. That shit was funny. I give him that. You know what I mean? But it took everything in me to keep my cool, man. It really did. And that's not the first situation. That's not the only situation. You're going to run into these situations, man. And it's all about keeping cool, man. Don't let these people take you off your square, man. The main focus of you being out here is getting them dollars, baby. So if somebody don't put their hands on you, man, squash it, man. Go go ahead about your business, brother. You know? Or let them know. Hey, man, what you gonna do? You gonna talk? You gonna pop shit? Or you know, once they put their hands on you, at that point, you're defending yourself. You know what I mean? Or you could just shut up and don't say anything and go about your day. That might be the best thing. But yeah, man, y'all keep it together, man. Don't let these people take you off your square and your paper, man. I just wanted to get that out there to y'all, man. And keep it pushing, man. Keep it pushing. My Truck Life 14, man.